Good morning, everyone. I hope you're doing great today. It is so beautiful here in Baldwin, Mississippi. That is right. I am back in Baldwin, Mississippi, and I had many people ask me why the change. What am I still doing the radio stuff? Am I okay? And this or that. And I just wanted to update everybody and let you know, yes, I'm okay. The change, the best answer I can give you on that is that it was just time. So God had taken me on this journey these past 3 years. And when I left Mississippi about 3 years ago, I was pursuing peace. I was pursuing just stability. I was pursuing calmness in my life. And at the time, I couldn't cope with many things that was going on around me. I felt like I couldn't find the support that I needed. And I did not know how to be there for myself in the middle of everything. So I'm so grateful that God took me to Milan, Tennessee. When I got to Milan, Tennessee, I wasn't sure how the community itself was going to be when I got there or what opportunities would be, but I ran on faith. So I took a leap of faith and I went and I found things. I found everything that I was looking for and I felt things that I needed that I didn't even know I needed, some of it. I learned how to do things differently. God connected me with an awesome team, helped me understand the areas that I was doing, going about things wrong, and gave me an awesome mentor and coach. So when that happened, I started, my mind started opening up to the understanding and realization that I needed to support myself better. I needed to learn how to motivate myself better and to be there for myself better. And I thought I was like, you know, why am I, I'm the only one that cares about blah, blah, blah. Well, I mean, I might have cared, but I didn't know how to handle myself the best that I should have been handling myself. So I didn't know how to love myself the way I should have been. So when I got to Milan, the community was so welcoming to me. And I just want to say thank you, Milan, Tennessee. If anybody's looking for a place to go visit or a place to go and live, Milan, Tennessee is it. So Milan has been super supportive of the things that we've had going on. Even when I first opened up the art studio and me and Lisa got that going and David, we got in there and we done what we were doing. And it was just, I was able to be myself. I was able to talk to people and open up and just be who I wanted to be. And it was fine. And that allowed me to have room to grow. So again, thank you, Milan. So I'm still doing the radio stuff. I've been moving. I got Wi-Fi on not too long ago here. We got that, and then we got stuff moved and have been busy nonstop. I always like to try to stay busy anyways to keep myself focused, but we've been busy lately because we needed to be. Moving stuff, cleaning stuff, just organizing stuff, getting stuff ready, and this and that. So I'm back in Baldwin, and which is, I feel at home here. When I was young, my grandmother and grandfather raised me and my sister for a while, and it was home to me, and I had peace then, and I have peace now. So now it's just the time for me to come back. Now I'm fixing to start planting seeds here in Baldwin and in Boonville, along with Milan. I'm not losing my connection. I'm not losing my friends. I've made so many friends during all this change, and people that have just swooped in to support me. And I love every one of you so dearly, and I'm so grateful for you all. God is doing something, and we don't always know what he's up to. We just have to step out sometimes with a leap of faith and trust him to guide us through the process. And when we do that, he gives us wisdom, he gives us understanding, he gives us clarity to what it is we're supposed to be doing in the now. It is not always what we should be doing next. Or sometimes it's not even understanding of what we just got through going through, you know, the experience, the lessons learned. Sometimes we understand that even a little bit later. But our focus, if it's on the now, then God can help us in the now. And we can become stronger. We can become mentally stronger. We can become ready. And that's what I feel like I am. So I'm back here and I'm ready. So ready and so eager and so excited, and just to pursue this mission and continue this vision that God has given me and my team. We are aimed to help people. We are building up a resilient recovery support community by Broadcast Communications. We're going to see where it's going to go, what God's going to do, by reaching out and doing things the best we can in faith and connecting with those who are seeking recovery or loss of mental illness. You're not alone, and your story is important. You are important, and you're valuable. You do not have to go through the struggles and challenges you do alone. Sometimes we feel like we're alone, like I did when I wasn't there for myself. You know, I wasn't there to be there for myself. If I had been, I may not have felt so alone. But besides that, we are a group of people who want you to be a part of what we're doing. We want to let you know how important you are, because you are, and you're needed. And people need to hear your story. People need to hear how you cope with things, because everybody struggles in this life. Everybody goes through different things, different ways, and we're all independently different. But one thing we can say we can come together on is support and love. And that's why we're doing what we're doing, is to be there for people who may feel like they're left behind, people that feel like there are no options, and people that feel like they're all out of hope. You know, you're not out of hope, even when it feels like it, and it's worth continuing to reach and search for your recovery. You know, and you do it at your own pace. Don't let nobody tell you that you can't do things the way you need to do things. I had to leave my home state to find my recovery, to find my peace, to find my strength, to find education, the wisdom to know how to do what I needed to do. And now I'm back here, and I'm hoping that people here will want to be a part of this. I'm going to be updating y'all soon on more stuff as I go along. I've been a little more slower, even as slow as I have been at times on different things, but that's because I have to go at my own pace. I used to rush into everything, and y'all know I used to rush into everything. Now I understand the importance of doing things in the now, and why it's more valuable doing things in the now. So anyways, I just woke up not too long ago, and I wanted to jump on here and say hey, because I haven't been on here in a minute. I love you all. Thank you all for the support. Still doing great. Still doing the radio stuff. Still doing other stuff, and I'm still staying busy, and I still have my faith. So, y'all have a great day, and I will be talking with you soon. And if you're seeking recovery or lost in addiction, reach out to somebody close to you for help. Don't feel ashamed, you know, that you're going through what you're going through, to the point where you don't want to talk to somebody about it. If anybody wants to talk to me, you can message me on Facebook, or you can email me at dwallace@tentalk.org. I'm here anytime that you need somebody to talk to, or if you just need me to listen. It'll be 100% confidential. And if you just want to get something off your chest or have a question, just reach out to me. That's what I'm here for, is to share my story with you and to try to help you better your own life in what ways that I can. So this life is beautiful. And it's a beautiful day in Baldwin, Mississippi. Y'all have a great one, and I'll talk soon.